Hey guys, I'm Anil, and this is Pockit. Today I'll try to put together these blocks into a compact and customizable Linux PC, and then turn it into a handheld computer. The whole thing is instantly rearrangeable, so it's also easy to modify or add to it at runtime. For the new viewers, Pockit is a modular platform on top of which you can magnetically snap any combination of blocks to quickly create any type of gadget. A bit like Lego, but for electronics. The blocks each have their own special feature internally, but they all mate to Pockit's universal pattern of tiny magnetic and electrical contacts. In the last few months, the project has come far, including a redesign of the casing to fully enclose the magnets and protect them from environmental or impact damage. The birth of several new blocks, including a couple suggested by the Reddit community, and a control center. Stay tuned for upcoming demos on these. Now to the main topic. For the demo that I'll show today, it's important to note something. Pockit's newest design supports a really convenient modular integration of the Raspberry Pi. But why a Pi block? Pockit and its current blocks are already powerful enough for a huge number of applications. But sometimes you want to give Pockit a processing power boost for things like machine vision, networking, and programming. And that's where the Pi's 1.4 GHz Broadcom CPU comes in. It was important to make this like a modular block too. So the back of Pockit's newest PCB version contains a DDR connector, into which you can snap in this guy when you need it. The compute module, a super compact version of the Raspberry Pi. With this, essentially all the pins and capabilities of the powerful Broadcom chip become accessible to Pockit's circuit board, where they're routed to the usual grid on top. So a bunch of new feature blocks can now be plugged in. Also, when the compute module is attached, we end up with two brains working together. Pockit's own microcontroller does the job of interfacing with most of the traditional blocks, while the Pi processor can act as an accelerator for desktop class applications, or when you simply want to use Linux to play with LEDs, sensors, motors, or whatever other blocks. But how are the signals, many of them in high-speed territory, routed in such a tight space? One option is to use a bigger circuit board, but Pockit is meant to be compact. So I decided to go more dense instead. Much like a basic smartphone, the Pockit Core now uses a 6-layer PCB to accommodate all the signal buses and dedicated power planes, enhancing signal integrity and thermal dissipation. All this results in a better working board that also stays more cool. It's nice to see how far the project has come, from a rough strip board test done over one afternoon to now a complex circuit board optimized and iterated over a course of months. Now, I'd like to do a conceptual demo of what's possible with adding Raspberry Pi into Pockit's modular ecosystem. That's it for this time's demo. Now that Pockit's core processing is also flexible, this opens up an even bigger world of applications. I'd love to hear feedback and ideas from you guys. For the new viewers, check out pockit.ai for project details and pictures. And be sure to sign up there if you want to get notified for project updates and new demos. There's also a beta test waitlist. If you're interested, please apply by emailing anil@pockit.ai with the subject line Pockit Beta. See you all next time.